Shalom, brothers and sisters, Islam Moors, greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, you're now under the sounds of the voice of your brother, Taza Dot, an aggrieved man. All I know is I'm an aggrieved man. And for the record, this is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent counsel, and then please be advised. What I'm about to give you is for educational, informational, entertainment purposes only. The content of this video or any of my videos is provided for informational and entertainment purposes only and do not constitute legal advice. Legal advice should only be obtained directly from an attorney or a lawyer. The information in Taza Doc Sharbay's videos or any of his writings do not apply to legal advice. Keep this in mind, folks. Before I start, I want to say information is the key to success. What I give you is right knowledge. So whether you're giving it or receiving it, whether you're selling it or you're buying it, the right information, right knowledge can make you a millionaire. And that doesn't mean necessarily in fiat currency, but also in your mind. So, do you want to be a vagrant? Or do you want to be a millionaire in your mind? That's the question. So with that being said, today's topic, and I would like to give a shout out to Mel B. I hope that situation worked out well for you in England. Keep fighting a good fight, Mel B. Today's topic I entitled How to Stop Constables on Patrol, Cops, and Policeman. Policeman, do not fear the cop or anyone. That is my subject. Such an interesting subject. So let's jump right into it. But I would say, prior to jumping into this, if you find the information in this video of value, and this information is of extreme value, it is very valuable, it is priceless, then kindly click the PayPal link below the video and donate whatever value you may find the information, my time, and energy to be worth. If you need some guidance or personal coaching, click the email link below and someone would actually be in contact with you. So with that being said, I just wanted to inform you. I told you this years ago, you know, I'm often, you know, pulled over by constables on patrol, I'm harassed, I'm labeled as insane, a lunatic, by the policymakers, and even many of you, viewers. You're entitled to your own opinion, but I'm still standing. But I warn you, folks, there is a subversive movement that intends to eliminate those of us that are trying to awaken the masses. I promise you. You know, I've had books. I've gotten my hands on some of their books, like anti-government handbooks that they actually teach their policymakers and their judges and their lawyers to apply in these color law courts that you go into. And many of you, you wonder why your documents are being ignored and certain procedures are being ignored. It's because they're trained to do so. They literally have anti-government handbook guides to teach them how to respond to those of us that have awakened. And they teach them that we are indeed crazy, foolish. You know, an idiot. And yeah, I'm an idiot from the standpoint that I exist outside of your society. But, folks, while on the one hand, the sterling efforts of the UK and the US and many others to expose this insidious corruption of common purpose and all of this color of law nonsense and the pedophilia are to be thoroughly recommended. And the antidote is right knowledge. And I intend to provide you with just that in this particular video, right knowledge, which is priceless. The information that I'm about to provide you with, folks, I encourage you to watch this video at least 4 times. But as usual, I always recommend 10 to embed it into your subconscious mind. I don't know how much longer I'm going to be able to share this information with you. They're trying to shut me down. They don't want voices like mine. Hey, it's to my surprise, they may tamper with my conveyance. You know, I go out to my conveyance, it may explode. They may, you know, pull me over, take me into a chamber or something and beat the life out of me. I don't know what to expect, but through the spirit of Yahweh Bahashem Yahawashah, through the spirit of my creator and his Hamashiach, I'm still standing and I'm still educating my fellow man. Fearless, the undaunted national. That's me. And by the way, tune into my other YouTube channel, The Undaunted National. So the information that I'm about to provide you with is priceless. So please click the PayPal link below and donate whatever value you may find it to be worth. Now, you can also help by giving the video a thumbs up and subscribing to the channel and telling others and waking up more people with right knowledge. This knowledge does not lie in mere exposure. Understand that. Now, for the simple reason that exposure is one thing, but connection to day-to-day activities is another, and considerably more complex. Do you understand? So this all being part of the plan of the globe controller, all being part of the plan of the banksters, who even control the judges and lawyers and the courts, these color law courts, to create a complexity that is difficult to see and unravel. So you could actually have, you know, a degree, a graduate degree in one of these so-called institutions of higher learning, and you cannot see what I'm talking about because they have actually made it very difficult to see and unravel. And I am therefore rendered as foolish as many others as myself. So what is necessary in practice are stone walls against all of this. Practical stone walls that they try and set it in place to shut me and others as myself down. Well, that's what lawful rebellion is. We're trying to teach or educate or entertain fellow man. So behind these walls of lawful rebellion, it matters not how one iota or how corrupt the monarchs of the parliament are, or whether the European Union even exists, or whether the common purpose exists, or whether the pedophilias in these Catholic churches and so on and so forth exist, and so on and so forth. Now, for the simple reason that you have actually placed yourself and your family behind their information and their misconstrued knowledge. Now, all of this is necessary, so I mean, to keep the confusion going. Now, all that is necessary for each and every decent man or woman to construct their own firewall, and every decent man or woman is safeguard against anything but nuclear attack, is to apply right knowledge through the spirit of the Most High Hamashiach. So what exactly is lawful rebellion, Tazadok? What are you talking about now? You come up with these crazy terms. Well, It's really very simple. Fundamentally, it's a mindset based on plain common sense and reason. The mindset is not to be afraid of anyone because everyone is equal. Does the judge have authority over you? Wait a minute. Is not there a maximum of law that says we're all equal under the law? Ask the black robe, are we all equal under the law? Then why are you fearing him? Why are you fearing him? See, now, it's very easy to say that, of course, but what about doing it? So the scriptures put it like this. The Heavenly Father says in Job 38 and 3, King James Version, gird up your loins like a man. So you have to be able to apply this. In order to be able to apply this, you must gird up your loins like a man. Well, that's actually nothing like as hard as it sounds. All it takes is some basic understanding, overstanding, and understanding about the facts of life. Now, first point, the understanding that the common law is the bedrock on which all civil legislation is built, simply because it is civil legislation, civilized and honorable behavior, and that's all it is. That's all the common law is, to act honorably. Therefore, if you understand civilized behavior, then you understand the common law. The scripture said it like this. Treat others as you want to be treated. I'm paraphrasing, of course, do unto others as you would have them to do unto you. And if you understand common law, which is civilized behavior, all you need to do is lock your mindset on it, folks. That's all you need to do. So once your mindset is locked into civilized behavior, everything you see around you becomes clearly defined. See, you are readily capable of detecting uncivilized behavior and thus able to immediately raise up the firewall to block it out. But if you don't have right knowledge, you won't see this. So the firewall consists in practice of nothing more than sensible, civilized, and reasonable questions. And these questions come simply from your understanding of what civilized behavior means. Now, anything and everything that is uncivilized is capable of being questioned. Now, for the simple reason that you know the question will not be answered by yardsticks derived from truth, decency, and honesty, and so on and so forth. Now, this method has very distinct advantages. See, it's actually built into the system of corruption that we all go up against on a daily basis, and must be that fact. Those who unwittingly perpetrate the system, this color of law system, must never realize they are doing so, but they do. So the systems of corruptions indoctrinated and ingrained in so many minds, and millions of minds grow up not realizing that they are being mind molded into uncivilized behaviors. So they go and get their degrees from their institutions of higher learning and do not realize that they're being manipulated, that they're being mentally manipulated, and they suffer from aphasia. So in short, when you ask such people reasonable, sensible, down to earth, very simple questions, they are immediately all at sea. They look at us like we're crazy. Some of you could be a witness to that. They are simply stunned for an answer because it does not compute with their indoctrinated mindset. So their basic reaction is simply to push the problem higher up the chain of command and forget about it as soon as possible. This actually does not help because the higher up the chain of command are similarly indoctrinated and have no more ideas than those below them. There's only a few. So the net result is that they steamroll, not one of them knowing what else to do. So they steamroll on, that is, until their ship eventually collides with the harbor walls. See, the harbor walls being your sensible, deceit, unanswerable questions. Now, at this point, they're not only at sea, but seriously torpedoed, billing out like, you know, a bum striking facts. Now, it's all about commerce, folks. And those are the levers you can actually use to build your firewall, folks. So in short, therefore, lawful rebellion is simply chuckling as many Spaniards as possible into the works. Now, the Spaniards simply being reasonable, fundamentally unanswerable questions. Now, if there is no corruption, if everyone and everything was acting decently and honestly in the first place, then those questions would actually not need to be asked. They would not be necessary and would simply not apply. Why is it necessary to ask the questions, Tyler Doc? Because you have constables on patrol. You have policy men, policemen, cops, you know, that has actually elevated themselves above their public servant capacity and are executing a dictatorship. So thus, the whole situation is out of control. Now, as far as the questions are concerned, you make them up. Make them up as you go along. You'll know in your heart what's right, brothers and sisters, and you'll know in your heart what's wrong. You'll also know in your heart what to say. So it's all in general based on authority. On authority. And the fact that in order for another to have any authority over you, you must extend it to them. Gird up your loins like a man. Job 38:3. You must make the conscious a subconscious effort to bend to their will. To their will. Do you understand? Yeah, you understand because you're standing under their authority. But I really want to ask, do you overstand? Do you understand? See, you must make the conscious a subconscious effort to bend to their wills and suppress your own will. So just don't do it, folks, for entertainment purposes. Don't bend to their will. Cling like a crab to your own free will. Now, I'm not inciting anything. I'm just telling you to gird up your loins like a man, just as the scripture says in Job 38, verse 3. So the first question to ask the constable on patrol, I'm going to show you how to beat any cop, constable on patrol, or policeman, policeman. The first question to ask is, what is your authority to place that demand on me? See, it's just a question. Where does your authority come from? That's the next question. Where and when did I, of my own free will, not under duress or deception, promise any obligation to you? See, these are the questions that you ask the constable on patrol, that you ask the policeman, the policeman. Where is it? Show me some document of proof. You see that? Things that were raging red hot suddenly go very cold when such questions are asked. What did I tell you years ago? He that is asking is as king. He that is as king is as the king. That's who's in charge. The policy man comes up to your conveyance and asks you questions, and you submit. See, that's basically where it starts, and that's lawful rebellion. And these questions apply to courts, police, local authorities, and everyone. You see, this is why that constable on patrol became irate with Sandra Bland. Why? Because she dared to ask questions and he couldn't tolerate it. So be careful when you do this, folks, for entertainment purposes. See, the vast majority of lawful rebellion takes, and I'm saying lawful rebellion, because you must resist the tyranny. You must rebel. This is not about overthrowing any government. This is about asserting your rights. All I know is I'm just an aggrieved man fighting for my rights. So the vast majority of lawful rebellion takes the form of correspondence and does not ever become physical. You know, you don't get into a physical altercation with them, do you understand? So however, there may be instances where the steamroller gets too physical, as it did with Sandra Bland. Because they cannot tolerate those of us that stand up and assert our inalienable rights. Bailiffs on your doorstep. Maybe even be accompanied by a policy man. A policy man. Policeman, to those of you that don't know. So perhaps, brothers and sisters, the ultimate thing to remember is this. Common assault is a crime, punishable by a prison sentence. And common assault is defined as anything that may cause you to feel unlawfully threatened. It does not have to be physical. It can be purely mental. Do you understand what your brother is saying? Do you understand? So thus, when approached in any kind of threatening manner, when they have no authority or jurisdiction to do so, you are being assaulted. And whoever is approaching you is committing a crime. Do you understand? It's not legal advice. It's not legal advice. I don't give it. If you need that, you're going to have to seek counsel. Now, such an approach is the minutes of a trespass upon. It's the minutes of a trespass upon. It's a minutes against a trespass upon what? Tyler Dock. It's a minutes against the trespass upon the national of your portion. Against the sovereign of your portion. And should you have no hesitation in saying so, no matter who is approaching you and whether or not he or she is wearing a blue cloth uniform, the boys in blue, with Masonic symbols attached, simply me, I use a commanding voice, hold it right there. Hold it right there, bro. Tori, that's the man. I don't engage the uniform. Hold it right there, bro. Take one more step, and the sky could easily fall in on you because I'll have you for a common assault in front of witnesses. You see, I want to say this in front of witnesses because you do not want to end up like Sandra Bland. So before taking that one more step, Mr. Constable on Patrol, find out whether or not I can do that. I assure you I can. And I will. Because I know the law of the land. Even if you apparently don't. And most of you don't. So you need some jurisdiction over me before I'm not able to report you for trespass. So let's discuss your jurisdiction, Mr. Constable on Patrol, Mr. Policy Man, shall we? See, these are just questions that I'm relaying to the Constable on Patrol, that I'm relaying to the Policy Man. So before you end up behind bars, Mr. Policy Man. So that would be the best idea, don't you think? See, gird up your loins like a man. Job 38, verse 3. Now, I know you feel pretty safe behind that uniform, but that's only because very few people understand the law and their rights. See, this is me talking to the policy man, the constable on patrol, and I'm not in that category. I know my rights, and I know yours, even if you don't. Now, have I caused injury or loss to anyone? See, these are the questions to the constable on patrol that pulled me over. To the policy man, no. Have I breached the peace? No. Have I been devious in my promise and agreement? In a contract? Have I created mischief in a contract? No. In that case, you are way outside of your jurisdiction and come close to criminal trespass. Do you understand, Mr. Policy Man? So back off and stay there. You're talking bold. Job says, gird up your loins like a man. Now, I'm not telling you got to do this. I'm just telling you how I interact if I so elect to do so. So your so-called authority is a house of cards built on sand. And it's obviously long past. You realize that? Do you realize that? Right now, before we go any further, Mr. Policy Man, Mr. Constable on Patrol, show me documented proof of your authority and jurisdiction, and let's discuss its limitation, because there are many of them. You have many limitations. Did you take an oath of service in order to wear that uniform in public? Was it solemn? We can start from there. Would you like to repeat that for me, Mr. Policy Man? See, brothers and sisters, you will be standing in front of a quite perplexed constable on patrol, a policy man, and possibly slightly scary. But, you know, you just render this in a respectful manner. See, it just takes bottles, which comes from the knowledge that you have rights on your side when you have the right knowledge, and a mouth with which to express your right, changing your tones of voice when appropriate. Job 38 and 3, gird up your loins like a man. So brothers and sisters, with that, I'm going to bring this one to a close. If you found this video to be valuable, please click the PayPal link below the video and donate whatever value you may find this video to be worth. If you would like some personal coaching, click the PayPal link below. I'm sorry, click the email link below and someone will be in contact with you as promptly as possible. If you're interested in becoming a secured party creditor, then click the email link below the video and someone will be in contact with you as promptly as possible. This information is based on practical experiences, folks, of various people. It's not just made up. If you show any kind of fear, and you're done. If you show them any kind of fear, you're done. Job 38 and 3, gird up your loins like a man. If you show fear, your goose is stewed. Your goose is fully cooked. Stand up for yourself. Know your right, which is in your heart, and it's possible. And people have sworn that a situation can be turned around to your favor, according to the Magna Carta 1215. It is, and you two, you people in England, to you folks that's listening to me in England, because I know you see Taz the Doc all around the world. And pretty soon, I know they're going to try and do away with me. But to all of you folks in England, according to the Magna Carta 1215, it is every English man's right, duty, to do this. And thereby, keep the corruption in check. And same for you and America. And with that, I'm going to say shalom to you all. May the Heavenly Father send his blessings upon you and give you the strength and the fearless energy to fight for your right as an aggrieved man or an aggrieved woman. So until next time, tell the Doc Side Bay, signing out. I'm going to say shalom, peace and blessings to you all.